Yes.
Hello.
Hello.
Good afternoon. My name is Zachary Belnavis. I'm a first year medical student at Florida Atlantic University. Can you please tell me your name?
Mary Anthony.
Mary Anthony. Okay. Very good to meet you, Mary Anthony. And how old are you?
19.
19. Okay. Do you prefer to be addressed as a male or a female?
A female.
Female. Okay. And before we begin, I just want to make sure that you're comfortable. Do you want me to turn on the light?
No.
Or you don't have to go out too cold or anything like that?
Mm-hmm.
No? Okay. Great. And also, do you need a chaperone at all? No? Okay. So today I'm gonna be conducting a head, eyes, ears, nose, and throat exam for you. Okay, so it should take about 15 minutes. Is that okay? Do you have any time constraints?
No, that's fine.
No? Okay, so I'm just gonna go ahead and start with an examination of your skull, if you don't mind. Okay, so just examining visually. I'm taking a look for any signs of asymmetry, any lesions, or anything of the sort. Seeing none, I'm gonna go ahead and do an examination of your scalp. Okay, so I'm gonna have to touch you here. All right. So I'm looking for here for any occult lesions, anything that I might not have been able to see with my initial examination. But everything seems okay. So I'm gonna go ahead and move on to the next part of the exam, which is the visual component of the exam. Okay. So first, with this particular eye chart, I'm going to be 14 inches away from you. This might vary depending on what eye chart I'm actually using. But for today, I'm going to ask you to read the smallest line that you're able to read. Okay? First cover one eye. Now try to tell me which line you can read.
The second to last one below.
Can you read the numbers there for me, please?
Yeah, 4, 1, and then 20/25.
Okay, great. And then now with your other eye. Can you read the letters this time of the lowest line that you're able to read?
3, 1, plus, and 20/20.
Okay, good. Okay, next I'm gonna go ahead and inspect your conjunctiva. Okay, so I'm gonna have to touch you again. All right. And here I see that I don't see any signs of any redness or lesion, and as well as the other visual component of this exam. I don't see any signs of jaundice. Your eyes appear to be reactive and symmetrical in terms of their movements. Okay, so next I'm going to go ahead and do an examination of your pupillary response. Okay, so first I'm going to do the normal pupillary response as well as the consensual in your other eye. Okay, and while I'm doing this, I'm just going to look straight at that PRL sign over there. Okay, so again in your left eye this time. Normal and then consensual. Okay, very good. Next, I'm going to check the right eye. Not this. With my otoscope. Okay. Now I'm going to make sure that your eyes are responding correctly, giving the red eye a response in both eyes. They do. Very good. Next, I'm going to go ahead and check your retinas. Okay. So if you don't mind, again, just keep on staring directly ahead of that PRL and come in from the, is your right side, so I'm coming in from my right side, getting a good look and focusing as I go in closer and closer. Okay, very good. And then again, on your left-hand side. All right. Okay, very good. Now I'm just going to do a quick examination of your lacrimal glands. Okay, so this time you can relax a little bit. I'm just going to do a quick visual inspection first, and seeing there, I don't see any signs of swelling or any sort of signs of inflammation, such as redness or any signs of lesions or anything like that. So then, next I'm going to go ahead and palpate, okay? Is there any pain as I do this?
Mm-mm.
No? Okay, very good. So next we're going to move on to the auditory component of the exam, all right? So first of all, I'm just going to do a quick visual examination of your ears. So I'm looking at structures such as the tragus as well as the pinna, external pinna. And from that, I don't see any signs of any exudate or lesions, rashes, bumps, or anything of the sort. And I'm just going to palpate your tragus, okay? Is there any pain as I do that?
Mm-mm.
No? Okay, very good. And I'm going to do a quick examination of your ear canal, okay? Make sure that stays in. Okay. So I'm pulling the ear back towards me and back. And while I'm doing this, I'm inspecting the tympanic membrane. Okay. this on both ears. Okay. So next I'm gonna do a quick sort of rough examination of your hearing. Oop. Also, something I forgot with the eyes. I'm just going to ask you to track my finger as I move it. Okay, so just keep your eyes on my finger. Okay, very good. Now, if you don't mind covering one, I'm just going to test your visual fields. Okay, so I'm going to hold up a number, either 1, 2, or 5, and you're going to, while looking directly at me, tell me what number you see. Okay, so.
5.
Okay, very good. Now with your other eye. Okay.
5, 2, 1, 5.
Very good. Okay, now to continue with your auditory examination, I'm gonna do the finger rub test. Okay, so if you don't mind when I rub my fingers, tell me which side you hear the rubbing on. Okay.
On my right side.
Very good.
My left side.
Good. Okay. Now I'm going to go ahead and conduct the ringing and Weber test, okay? So I'm just gonna ask you to tell me when you can't hear the noise, okay?
I can't.
Okay, how about now?
I can't.
Okay, that was Weber test, now I'm gonna do the Rene test. Can you hear this? So next I'm just going to do an examination of your oral cavity, aka your mouth. Okay, so first of all, just by visual inspection, I don't see any signs of Klotz lesions, any sort of redness or anything else that might indicate inflammation or anything, or any sign of dehydration such as dry lips. Okay, so next I'm going to go ahead and grab some gloves. It's going to feel a little bit like being in the dentist, but trust me, it's going to be fine. I hate the dentist too. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and grab a tongue depressor over here. Do we have any in this room? That's better. Okay, so first of all, I'm just gonna ask you to open your mouth for me, please. Okay, now I'm gonna check your pharynx. So when I say so, can you just say uh-huh? Okay, let's get like a light so I can see a little bit better. Okay, open your mouth, and then one last time, say ah for me, please. Okay, very good. And then can you just keep your mouth open while you're doing this? I'm just gonna inspect the roof of your mouth, your cheeks. And do you mind lifting up your tongue like this? Very good. So I'm checking the underside of your tongue now. And now I'm just gonna check your gums. Okay, and while I'm doing this, I'm looking for any signs of lesion, any sort of white exudates or any signs of inflammation, but seeing none, I'm gonna go ahead and conclude that portion of the exam. I conclude. Now, the next portion of the exam is the nasal aspect of the exam, okay? So I'm just gonna again take a quick look. Visually, your nose seems good and symmetric. I don't see any signs of any lesions or rashes or anything of the sort. Have you been experiencing have you had a flu or anything like that recently?
No.
No? Okay. So next I'm gonna go ahead and take a look at your nasal septum, okay? So again I'm just gonna go in. So if you don't mind just leaning your head just back a little bit. Okay, very good. Okay, so now I'm checking for any nasal septum deviations in addition to any tears or holes that might have occurred there. Okay. final part of the exam. I'm gonna go ahead and do a quick examination of your throat.
Okay. So first of all, just by looking, I'm looking for any signs of tracheal deviation, but I don't see any, as well as I don't see any signs of rashes or any inflammation of that sort.
Okay.
So I'm gonna try to get a handle of your thyroid gland.
Okay.
So it should be right below your cricoid cartilage, which is about there. Here-ish. Okay, so now I'm just gonna put my hands like this. Okay, I'm just gonna ask you to swallow for me, please. Okay, I was able to feel your...
That was the thyroid cartilage. Oh. I think that you were on.
Oh. And I think that concludes the exam. So do you have any questions for me?
Mm-hmm.
No? Okay, great. I'm gonna take this information to my attendant. The final part of the exam, I'm just gonna show how to examine the lymph nodes of the head.
Okay.
So first we're going to start with the occipital. So if you don't mind, I'm going to go ahead and reach around you.
Okay.
So the occipital node behind the skull and the postauricular, preauricular, tonsillar, submandibular, submental, the cervical chain, which has both a medial and lateral component, as well as the, I'm just going to have to reach a little bit through this, okay, as well as the supraclavicular nodes, but I don't feel anything. So there's no signs of a phalaenopathy. Great.